Today on BRS TV's How To Tuesday, we're going to show you how to know for sure when your carbon blocks need to be replaced. Hi, my name's Ryan and you're host of BRS TV, where each week we hit on a new topic related to reefing. This week we're going to show you how to test your filters and identify when to change them. Carbon blocks serve two main purposes: removing chemicals like herbicides, pesticides, cancer-causing disinfection byproducts like trihalomethanes, and a whole slew of other things in well and municipal water supplies, most of which the RO membrane alone is not very effective at removing. The second thing we're concerned about is protecting the RO membrane from chlorine. Chlorine will oxidize the surface of the membrane and destroy it. Reefers rely on this membrane to reduce harmful metals, nitrates, minerals, and other dissolved solids. A typical membrane can be destroyed with as little as 200 hours of contact with water containing as little as 1 part per million chlorine, so maintaining the carbon blocks is critical. The most common recommendation is to swap them out every 6 to 12 months, depending on the size of your tank and water consumption. Well, this isn't bad advice. Most people are likely changing them too early and wasting some money. Another option is to go by the gallon rating provided by the manufacturer. This also isn't a bad option. However, there are a few challenges. First, chlorine capacity is rated at 1 gallon per minute. Most common reef RODI systems are closer to 1/4 gallon per minute, which means your block could last significantly longer. These ratings are also based on manufacturer testing in a controlled environment at a specific pH, temperature, flow rate, and specific amount of free chlorine, none of which are likely to be the exact same at your household. Lastly, most of the specs are based on 85% to 90% removal. Many of you might not want to wait until 15% of the chlorine is breaking through. So what are you supposed to do? The best option is just test for chlorine so you know for sure. It's likely doing this will actually save you money and get maximum lifespan out of your filters. The tests are super simple. There's test strips like this. We just dip one end in, give it a quick shake, and it instantly tells you your total and free chlorine. There's some test kits which are a bit easier to read, and even popular checkers that give a digital readout and give resolution all the way down to 0.01 parts per million. There are a variety of ways to test the carbon blocks. Best is probably to remove one end of the tube that's exiting the last carbon block. Another way, which might be more convenient for some, is to test the water exiting the wastewater line, which is water that's passed through the RO canister but hasn't actually gone through the RO membrane itself. You'll notice that there are two testing options, total and free chlorine. If you were only to get one, it should be a total chlorine test. Total chlorine, as the name suggests, a total volume of chlorine in the water and includes both chlorine and chloramines. Testing for free chlorine as well will help you identify which type of disinfectant your city uses. Free chlorine will only show hypochlorite, which most people refer to as chlorine. The other common type of disinfectant is known as chloramines, which is now used in an estimated 25 to 30% of households. Expect this number to grow every year because there's some significant advantages to municipal water supplies as they try to meet the new EPA standards for disinfection byproducts. Difference between chlorine and chloramines is chloramines are chlorine reacted with ammonia, which makes it a more stable disinfectant. However, it's that stability that makes them harder to remove, and the removal process will result in some ammonia in the product water, which is pretty undesirable to most reef tank owners. For that reason, most of you will want to find out what your city uses by giving them a quick call. Lastly, the biggest killer of carbon blocks is most often just sediment in your water supply, which can clog the surface of your block. So make sure to swap out those sediment filters on time. Easiest way to know when they're getting clogged is a simple pressure gauge installed after the pre-filters and before the membrane. A drop in pressure signifies the sediment filter is getting clogged and should be changed. If you have any questions about any of this, check out the comments area down below. If this is your first time with us, hit that subscribe button because we do this every week. See you next Tuesday with another BRS TV How To.